Okay, today we're gonna make us a triple layer chocolate pie using some famous wafers that a good friend of mine, Marlene, in Delray, California, sent me. Thanks a lot, Marlene. Also, in the new issue of Southern Living, or the March issue anyway, they got a recipe in here for pecan crusted chicken tenders, which is basically kind of like shake and bake, I guess. They're using crackers, and it's baked in the oven is what it's done, and they bake them on a wire rack on a baking sheet. So I'm going to do the same thing using steak and make chicken fried steak in the oven. And I'm going to use three different toppings. I'm going to use crushed saltines. I'm going to use some Ritz crushed. And I'm also going to do it a few of them with some crushed corn flakes. And they got a tip in here. And it was saying that if you're going to do this stuff in the oven, after you get all your crust on it, you know, you dunk it in the egg and the flour and all that stuff, you spray the surface down with some cooking spray. Just kind of a light coating on both sides, and you put it on that rack and bake it off at about 425 for 18 to 20 minutes and turn at about 12 minutes. You gotta flip it. So we're gonna give that a shot. Alright, so I done ground up 1.5 cups plus a couple of extra crackers and then famous wafers. Got the sugar in there. I done melted some butter right here, and I'm fitting to mix all that up. I'm glad I didn't pour it in the wrong place. I also sprayed some cooking spray in that pie pan. I was going to use a regular pie pan, a glass one, but it looked like this triple layer pie is going to occupy more space. So we're going to put it in this deep dish. What JP done is I whipped together some cream cheese with some Hershey's cocoa mix and some Cool Whip type topping. This one, this way you don't have to bake that. You do got to bake the cookie crust to kind of make it form. Alright, so I got that cooling in the refrigerator. I'm fitting to pour that in there. But first I got to make this cook and serve pudding and pie filling mix. It is cook and serve. And so, shut up, phone. Wait, let me go kill it. Alright, and what I'm gonna do to the pudding mix is add some dark chocolate chips to it. Tighten it up. Step two. The cheesecake filling. It's on top. Alright, there's the pudding mix. And I got about that many semi-sweet chocolate chip pieces, and we're going to add to it. Alright, here we go. Just right on top. Now here's where to eat them if you got them. Leftover cookies come in the plate. Kind of like a banana cream pie. Even if you got a broke one. Or one that JB took a bite out of. Stick it in there. Alright, we're going to continue with this. Alright, so here's what we got. I got some corn flakes, and I'm busting them up. I had already busted up some saltines, some Ritz, now the corn flakes. Just bust them all up, and we're going to make a breading for, come on boy, bust up. Alright, so here's what we're going to do. We're going to take a little slap of your mama, put it in there with some flour, boy. Come on, pay attention. A little more flour. A little more flour, boy. Come on, pay attention. I got it on your lens. Tough. Here you go. Pay attention. We're gonna put a little bit of salt or pepper. No, hell no. We're gonna put some slap your mama in there. Whoop that all up like that. You always want to put your meat in the flour first, then the egg wash. Reason being is that flour helps seal the meat. Alright, like I said, we're going to take some cooking spray, and you see over here, boy, and spray this down. Alright. Alright, here go the first one. Come out of there, boy. Flour first. It's seasoned flour with slap your mama. Alright. Into the seasoned egg wash. Over here, boy. Pay attention. Seasoned egg wash. Then we're going to put this one in the crackers. Saltine crackers. Just like that. Right? Pat them in good too. There we go. That's what we want to see. Right? I'm going to put that on the thing over there. There's three different ones right there. Corn flakes, Ritz, saltines. Dirty hand. I'm going to wash my hands and do the rest of them. Here we go. We got cornflake, Ritz, regular crackers, and a hybrid. The hybrid has got a mix of everything on it. Now, according to Southern Living, this is the trick. You take and put a light coating of cooking oil on it, just like that, the spray stuff. We'll put a little more, and you go bake it off in a hot oven. I'm talking about 425, boy. So, how does JB make fresh homemade garlic bread? I go buy a loaf of it and cook it like it says. How about that? I'm going to use half the loaf today. Put the other half up for later. Come on, half loaf. Let's go get the oven. Jump in there, boy. Go, 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 go. Cook, cook, cook.
Cook, boy. Cook, boy. Here we go. We got, dredge them in the flour, dunk them in the egg wash, and then put them, I'm going to do each one, just pay attention.